Hello friends, subscribe to our channel GDC and press the bell icon for more updates.
Hello pharma aspirants, welcome to GDC. In this video, we will be discussing about the flow properties and their measurement. So, flow property, what is flow property? Flow property, that is flow ability, is defined as the ability of a powder to flow in a desired manner in a specific piece of equipment. Flow of powder may be of two types, free flowing and non-flowing. Non-flowing is also known as cohesive. So, during the manufacturing of tablets, capsule, filling of powder in a container, it involves several powder handling steps, including blending, transferring, storing and feeding. So the inability to achieve reliable powder flow during these steps can have significant adverse effect on the manufacturing and release of product. So due to these reasons, it is important to measure the flow property of powder. So we can measure the flow property of powder by angle of repose. So this is a method in which we measure the flow property. Formula used is theta equals to tan inverse upon h by r, where theta is the angle of repose and tan is the unit trigonometric, h is the height of pile and r is the radius of base of the pile. So in this method, a support is there from which a stand is connected and a stool like structure is made. It is the mechanism for lifting up and down this surface, and from the support a funnel is attached into a specific distance. Now what happens is we put the powder into the funnel and the powder flow through the funnel, forming a pile like structure. We measure the radius of the pile and the height of the powder pile. So the angle between R and H is known as angle of repose. The internal angle between the surface of pile and the horizontal surface is known as angle of repose. The angle of repose majorly depends on density, surface area, shape of particles and coefficient of friction. Basically, the angle of repose is always between the angle 0 to 90 degree. It is the range of angle of repose. Angle of repose method uses interparticulate friction or resistance to move between the particles. And by the static, there are three methods to determine static angle of repose. First is fixed height method, second is fixed base diameter method, and third is tilting box method. And dynamic angle of repose is measured by revolving cylinder method. Then the units, powder flow excellent powder flow having angle of repose 25 to 30 degree. Good powder flow is considered when the powder have angle of repose 30 to 40 degree. Passable means 40 to 50 degree, and very poor means 50 to 60 degree. Now these flow has subcategories, which I am telling that excellent has 25 to 30 degree, good have 31 to 35 degree, and fair, that is aid not needed, 36 to 40 degree. Passable 41 to 45 degree, poor 46 to 55, very poor 56 to 65 and very very poor more than 65. Those were the subcategories, but main categories excellent, that is 25 to 30 degree, good 30 to 40 degree, passable 40 to 50 and very poor 50 to 60. That was for flow property angle of repose. Another measurement for flow property is Carr's consolidation index and Hausner's ratio. So Carr's consolidation index, it is also known as Carr's index or compressibility index. The formula for Carr's index is tapped density minus bulk density divided by tapped density multiplied by 100. It has no unit. Hausner's ratio is calculated by tapped density divided by bulk density. Also, Hausner's ratio does not have any index. Now, Carr's index and Hausner's ratio both are determined by measuring the bulk volume and the tapped volume of the powder. Because for calculating the density, we need to know the mass and volume of the powder. Now, the Carr's index and Hausner's ratio has particular range by which we can determine the powder flow. We will be discussing those range. When the value of Carr's index is less than or equal to 10, it means powder has excellent flow. When it has value 11 to 15, it means powder has good flow. And when the value is between 16 to 20, flow has fair property. When value is between 21 to 25, powder is passable. When range is 26 to 31, powder is flow property is poor. And when the value is 32 to 37, powder flow property is very poor. And when the value is more than 37, the powder has very very poor flow property. You can remember the Carr's index by this method, that each flow property is having a gap between 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 31, 37. That's it for remembering the Carr's index. Excellent flow has Carr's index less than or equal to 10. A good flow has Carr's index 11 to 15. Fair 16 to 20. Passable 21 to 25. Poor 26 to 31. Very poor 30 to 37. Very very poor has value of Carr's index more than 37. Now similarly, Hausner's ratio. When the value of Hausner's ratio is between 1 to 1.11, flow is considered as excellent. When it has value of 1.12 to 1.18, it is considered as good. For fair flow property, the powder has range of 1.19 to 1.25. Passable powder has a value of Hausner's ratio 1.26 to 1.34. Poor flow property of powder has the Hausner's ratio value 1.35 to 1.45. Very poor powder flow has the value of Hausner's ratio, that is 1.46 to 1.59. And when the Hausner's ratio value is more than 1.60, that is 1.6, the powder flow is considered as very very poor. This was the about Hausner's ratio and Carr's index, also known as Carr's consolidation index. And it is important to remember the range of Carr's index and Hausner's ratio and their equivalent value of powder flow. Thank you for watching this video.